Today we're going to talk about the conditions that can cause pain on the inner ankle. So that's pain from day-to-day activities, and we're also going to cover the conditions that can cause inner ankle pain from running. So first of all, the most common cause of pain on the inner ankle is from an ankle sprain. So that's when you turn your ankle outwards. So the more common form of sprain is turning the ankle inwards. Turning the ankle outwards is the stress that's placed on the deltoid ligaments. So you can see from the image, that's a web of ligaments that pass all the way across the inner ankle joint, and they provide stability and integrity to the joint. Not only do they have a superficial layer, but they have a deep layer that goes underneath the medial malleolus. So common causes of injury to these are trauma. So when playing sport, you can get a tackle from the outside that pushes the foot inward. When you land from a jump in sports like volleyball and basketball, if you can land on someone's foot or on an uneven surface, you can roll the ankle outwards and stress these ligaments. They normally cause an acute episode of pain, so you feel it immediately at the time. There may be some swelling, some instability of the joint, and the inability to weight bear. Often these are more painful than the lateral ankle sprain, and they typically give more complications. So these are one that should definitely be investigated by a physical therapist or a podiatrist. And often they lead to secondary conditions such as synovitis. So that's a type of swelling within the capsule of the ankle joint. So if you think of the joint itself, you've got a capsule that goes all around it, and you can get swelling within that capsule. Synovitis is a thicker form of swelling that sits within the joint, and it can cause irritation as you turn the ankle inward or outward, or as you bring your knee over your toes. One of the other most common forms of injury to the inner ankle is posterior tibial tendonitis or posterior tibial tendon dysfunction. Both of these affect the posterior tibial tendon, and that's a vital tendon within the foot. As you can see, it goes down along the inside of the shin, wraps around the medial malleolus, and then it connects primarily onto the navicular bone, but does split into 9 to 11 different parts, attaching throughout the medial arch of the foot and the underside of the foot. It plays a vital role in the structural integrity of the arch of the foot, and it works as a stabilizer of the foot as we turn it outwards, as we walk, as we move on unstable surfaces. So tendonitis is what we see most often in runners that causes inner ankle pain. And what happens with this is we get an overload of the tendon, which is typically true, a sudden increase in volume of running, or a change in the pace that we're running at, or sometimes it can be as simple as introducing some hill training as it places some extra stress in that posterior tibial tendon. As a result, we get some irritation of the tendon that causes pain on the inner ankle. Normally it's painful to hop, jump, or run on the ankle joint. Sometimes it can be painful to resist inward movement of the ankle joint. And often in the early stages of this condition, we get some pain at the start of a run, improves as we get warmed up, and then it can get painful towards the end of the run or afterwards. Then the following morning, it's often stiff and sore when you first step out of bed, and then eases after 5 to 10 minutes. As the condition deteriorates, it can be painful all activities, even with walking and standing. The slight difference with posterior tibial tendon dysfunction is that the tendon becomes weaker over time, and that allows the arch of the foot to drop, and in those patients they start to develop a condition called adult acquired flat foot. This is an important condition to identify for clinicians, and normally if you look in the mirror with your two heels, one heel starts to turn inward, and that's a sign that your posterior tibial tendon and possibly your spring ligament that sits underneath your foot isn't providing the support to the medial arch, and as a result your heel is starting to turn inwards and the arch height is starting to drop. Both of these conditions are thankfully rehabilitated with strengthening exercises, and we have another video on posterior tibial strengthening exercises that can be used for both conditions, and we'd recommend you watch it if you feel that that's a condition that you're suffering from. Other causes of inner ankle pain are a condition called tarsal tunnel syndrome. So under the medial malleolus, you can see there's a little groove, and through there we've got some nerves that run through, and they help to provide innervation, sensitivity and touch to the inner foot and underside of the foot. If they get impinged through a sudden movement such as an ankle sprain or through a reduction of mobility in the joint, it can irritate the nerves and give you pain along the inner ankle. The symptoms differentiate from that of a deltoid ligament sprain or posterior tibial tendon dysfunction or tendonitis, in that the pain is typically constant, it's there at rest. It can be exacerbated with activity, but normally with a sprain or with a tendon issue, the pain improves at rest and most of the time is pain-free. Well, you might have a dull low-level ache with tarsal tunnel syndrome while you're at rest, and you might also get some pins and needles tingling or numbness in the foot. Another cause of inner ankle pain is a condition called flexor hallucis longus tendinopathy. It's a bit of a mouthful, but it's essentially the long tendon that runs from the big toe all the way underneath the arch of the foot, around the medial malleolus, and then up onto the inner shin. Its primary function is to help flex the big toe joint, so we see it commonly affecting dancers, those that need to go up and point, so ballet dancers primarily, but most dancers require a lot of jumping activities and going up onto their toes, and that's something that is quite difficult to differentiate in clinic between flexor hallucis longus tendinopathy and posterior tibial tendonitis. But one of the key differences is that pain is elicited on resistance of your big toe flexion rather than inversion of the ankle joint. Finally, one of the other causes of inner ankle pain can be subtalar joint arthritis. So that's osteoarthritis of the subtalar joint. That joint helps to turn the ankle in and out. So we can develop arthritis through poor systemic health, history of trauma, or we can just get changes over time as we get older. And in those instances, what we typically see in those patients is that there's a reduced range of motion of the ankle, particularly when turning the ankle inward and outward. They often describe stiffness first thing in the morning when they get out of bed, or after they've sat for periods of time. That can ease a little bit as they get moving, but they are limited with their activity levels. So this is a condition that we typically see in older people. The tendon conditions, while they get stiffness and a similar pattern to subtalar joint arthritis, we typically see them in more active individuals. The only caveat to that is with an adult acquired flat foot, which can result from posterior tibial tendon dysfunction, often coexists with subtalar joint arthritis. So it's something to keep in mind. If you're an older individual, you're noticing a change in your foot position, you should really see a clinical specialist about it. So hopefully that's given you an insight into the conditions that can cause inner ankle pain. Primarily, you're likely to be looking at tendon issues if you're a runner with no mechanism of injury. If you sprained your ankle, it's likely stress to the deltoid ligament. If you're getting pins and needles and numbness in the foot, likely to be the tarsal tunnel syndrome. And if you're of a certain age and your ankle joint has come a bit stiff and swollen, it may be subtalar joint arthritis that's causing the pain. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. And if you found the video helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.